Yes.
Very handsome. Where do you get those things?
They're just extensions.
It's really important not to paint the light and shadows on the face in the same color, just light and dark. Then it looks kind of plastic and muddy looking. Often you'll find in the shadows of the face, you'll see a lot of greens, violets. Though if I was painting a face that had a lot more light in it, the shadows would be locked together more in one color, and I have more variety in the light, where you'd see kind of the same variety of colors, but just lighter versions, you know, orange, a little bit of light green, maybe a little light purple with it, and they read together. You see that, I mean, if you look in people's faces, there's all kinds of cool spots that we don't think of as flesh tones, that without, there's no form to the face. You usually find, you know, redder tones around the cheek and nose. Tends to get a little greener down here, especially in guys with the facial, you know, growth, stubble. But, you know, actually you find that's often a little cooler tones up in here, or sometimes even yellower tones. And when I'm painting color shifts in a face, I'm trying to describe some kind of a plane change. I'm not looking for a little lighter and darker as much as I am. You know, the top of the cheek is going to be one color. As it turns down, I'm going to change the color, which shows a turn in the same value.